a mama, I'm sure all the henna now, yes, around.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, good to see all of you here today. Thanks for coming out. It's too nice to be here sometimes. No. Now what am I saying? Hey, a couple quick things. First of all, if you didn't get any refreshments, particularly water because it is getting hot, or any other beverage you want, see the tent over here where we have all kinds of things for you. Second thing, I want to thank Arrowwood Lodge, who is a sponsor for this production. Please give them a round of applause. And I want to invite you back. Curtis. He likes doing that, just cutting me off in mid-sentence. That's okay. Come back in 2 weeks to see Sean Johnson's Big Band Experience. Do you know who Sean Johnson is from Tonic Solfa? Puts on a heck of a show with that band. He's got a band with the big band sound, but he takes some of the classics that you're more used to, more modern stuff, and gives them that big band sound. It's a great show full of high energy and fun right here on this stage, 2 p.m. October 3rd. Then we finalize our outdoor series on the 10th with the George Maurer Quartet, playing all kinds of great jazz standards right here. Please come back for that as well. Then we have events that will be streamed over the winter, but we'll tell you about those another time. Lucy, if Lucy would stick her head out from underneath the tent over there, I want to point out who Lucy is. She's our box office manager. She's waving. These kinds of events don't pay for themselves, even though we do charge an admission price, and all of you very, very generous folks paid that admission price. If you feel you got more than your money's worth, would you please see Lucy after the show and give her another dollar or two, and she'd love to take a donation from you. I'll quit pandering. This handsome gentleman back here is Levi. This striking gentleman here is Mark. And this lovely lady here is Lisa Lynn. And they are the Holy Rocka Rollaz.
Thank you so much, Patrick. How y'all doing out there? What a beautiful day we have, huh? Do you guys like 50s rock and roll? Johnny Cash. Patsy Cline. Elvis Presley. Let's kick it off with some Buddy Holly. What do you say? This one's called Not Fade Away. Go for it, buddy. It's one for the mind, two for the show, a three to get ready. Now go, cat, go, but don't you step on my sweatshirt.
got from my blue switch. You can knock me down, step on my face, slamming my name all over the place. Do anything that you want to do. Lay off of them shoes and don't you slip on my blue switch. I'm not in search of you. Well, you can go to my house, steal my car, drink my liquor from a fruit jar. Do anything that you want to do.
It's so easy.
It's so easy to fall in love. It's so easy to find love. People tell me love's for fools, so here I go, breaking all of the rules. It seems so easy.
It's so easy, it's so easy, it's so easy.
So doggone
easy.
From Buddy Holly to Buddy Knox. This one's called Party Doll.
Well, all I want is Party Doll. Come along with me when I'm feeling wild. To be in a love and true and fair. Running her fingers through my hair. Come along and be my Party Doll. Come along and be my Party Doll. Come along and be my Party Doll. She had blonde hair and eyes of blue. Or maybe I'm a
along and be my party doll. Come along and be my party doll. Come along and be my party doll. I'll make love to you, to you. I'll make love to you. Well, every man has got to have a party doll to be with him when he's feeling wild. To be in my love and true and fair, run her fingers through his hair. Run her fingers through his hair. Come along and be my party doll. Come along and be my party doll. Come along and be my party doll. I'll make love to you, to you. I'll make love to you. Be my party doll. Come along and be my party doll. Come along and be my party doll. I'll make love to you, to you. I'll make love to you.
Ooh, 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 ooh. All righty. What a beautiful day we were given. We thought we were going to be inside in the theater today, and what a joy it was to know we were going to be outside today. Woo! This is fun. This is a lot nicer than the first place this band ever had our show. The South Dakota State Pen. Prison Ministry. Who here seen that movie, Walk the Line, with Johnny Cash? Man, you guys know it. You know how to watch a movie. Well, you know that scene where all the inmates are clapping their hands and stomping their feet, and they're waiting for the man in black, right? I had a night like that. Just for the record, I never took her in there. I didn't think much ministry would happen that way. But we were doing it. We were having a great time. We were playing some old country gospel, and all of a sudden, these prison guards start rushing into the room. And then they started rushing towards me. And this guy, he had to have been 6'8". And he probably could have broke me in two with his pinky. He went like this. Keep in mind, dear people, this is a maximum security federal prison. I didn't know what that meant. So I looked at the chaplain who hired us. And I go, what do I do? He's like, just keep going. They let me do one more song, then they threw my guitar and my amplifier on a cart and wheeled me out to the front and threw me over the barbed wire fence. And I figured I was going to be getting a phone call when I got back to Minneapolis. And so, sure enough, the phone rang, and it's the chaplain. And he says, Mark, I got a favor to ask for you. I said, I know, I got a little out of hand, and the next time I come out, you probably want me to be a little bit more sedate. And he's like, oh, no. Next time you come, can you play Folsom Prison Blues? I said, Regan, I've been doing this for 6 years. I've stayed away from that song on purpose. You know the line, I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die? He's like, oh, yeah. It's their favorite part.
I hear the train coming. It's rolling around the bend. I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison and time keeps dragging on. That train keeps rolling on down the Santo. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. And I hear that whistle blowing, I hang my head and cry. Thank you.
Well, I bet there's rich folks eating in a fancy diner car. They're probably drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. Oh, I know I had it coming. I know I can't be free. Those people keep moving, and that's what tortures me.
Sing!
Prison. If this railroad train was mine, I bet I'd move it on a little farther down the line. Far from Folsom Prison, that's where I want to stay. And I'd let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away.
Thank you so much. We have been a band for 10 years now, and one of the main lessons we've learned is it's always good to follow Johnny Cash with Johnny Cash.
We got married in a fever, hotter than a pepper sprout. We've been talking about Jackson ever since that fire went out. Well, I'm going to Jackson. I'm going to mess around. I'm going to Jackson. Look out, Jackson Town.
Well, go on down to Jackson. Go ahead and wreck your hell. Go play.
Honey, I'm gonna snowball Jackson.
See if I can.
When I breeze into that city, people gonna stoop and bow. All them women gonna make me teach them what they don't know how. Well, I'm going to Jackson. You turn loose of my coat. I'm going to Jackson.
Goodbye is all she wrote. They'll laugh at you and Jackson, and I'll be dancing on a pony cat. They'll drag you around town like a scalded hound with your tail tucked between your legs. You're going to Jackson, you big talking man. I'll be waiting in Jackson behind my Japan fan.
We got
I fall to pieces each time I see you again. I fall to pieces. How can I be just your friend? You want me to act like we've never kissed. You want me to forget, pretend we've never met. Well, I tried and I tried, but I haven't yet. You walk by and I fall to pieces.
My lovely wife, Lisa Lynn, 24 years of marriage next month. She can sing Patsy, can't she? We'll have her do another one.
I've got your picture that you gave to me, and it's signed with love, just like it used to be. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got your picture, she's got you. I've got the records that we used to share, and they still sound the same as when you were here. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got the records, she's got you. I've got your memory, oh, has it got me? I really don't know, but I know it won't. Your class ring that proved you cared, and it still looks the same as when you gave it, dear. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got these little things, she's got you. I've got your memory, oh, has it got me? I really don't know, but I know it won't let me be. I've got your class ring that proved you cared, and it still looks the same as when you gave it, dear. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got these little things, she's got you.
Thank you.
We're going to have her sing another one here. Fun story behind this next song. Johnny Cash wrote and recorded this next song in 1960 in Sun Recording Studio in Memphis, Tennessee. It was released on the Sun record label. It was a minor hit for him, but his daughter, Roseanne Cash, has had a wonderful career as well. And she needed one more song for her record in 1985. And her husband and producer at the time, Rodney Crowell, said, Roseanne, I'd like to show you this song. So he grabbed a guitar and he played it for her. And she said, oh, I like that. So they recorded the song in the studio that night, and it became her first number one hit. This is the kicker. When she sang it, she had no idea that her daddy wrote it. The song is called Tennessee Flat Top Box.
In a little cabaret in a South Texas border town, sat a boy and his guitar. People came from all around, and all the girls from there to Austin were slipping away from home and putting jewelry in, hot to take a trip to go and listen to the little dark-haired boy who played the Tennessee flat top box, and he would play. And all the girls from 9 to 90 were snapping fingers, tapping toes, and begging him don't stop, and hypnotized and fascinated by the little dark-haired boy who played the Tennessee flat top box, and he would play. Like the breeze, they forgot him in the little town, but all the girls still dreamed about him and hung around the cabaret until the doors were locked. And then one day on the hit parade was a little dark-haired boy who played the Tennessee flat top box, and he would play.
How about that drummer, Levi Stugelmeyer, huh? That song doesn't sound that good unless he's playing it like that. Whew, what a beautiful day. It couldn't be any better. It could not be any better. You having fun? We are too. We had fun on our fall tour 2 years ago. We ended up in this town called Shenandoah, Iowa. Anybody heard of Shenandoah, Iowa? I see a few hands go up. Well, that's where the Everly Brothers grew up. They were born in Kentucky, but their daddy moved to Shenandoah, Iowa, because, believe it or not, there was a huge radio signal that came out of that area that covered almost all the United States and into Canada and Mexico. And he had dreams of being a musician, so he would bring his boys onto his radio show, and he'd put them in these matching Western suits. And this old guy came up to me after our show in Shenandoah. He says, can I tell you a fun story? He's like, yeah. He goes,
My dad kept the Everly Brothers from getting beat up by bullies every morning. I'm like, what do you mean? He's like, every day they'd come out of that studio and the bullies were waiting to beat them up in their Western suits. And my dad would take them into his shop, let them change into their school clothes, and then take them back to the school. And I'm like, I've never heard that story before. And I looked at the guy and I said, by chance, did you happen to go to school with the Everly Brothers? He goes, I did. And I said, well, we did a handful of Everly Brothers songs tonight. How'd we do? He went like this. So, well, I'm going to make a deal with you here. We're going to give you one song, and if I see just one thumb, we'll give you some more. But thumbs only, please, all right?
Wake up, little Susie, wake up. Wake up, little Susie, wake up. Susie and weep. The movie's over, it's 4 o'clock and we're in trouble deep. Wake up, little Susie. Wake up, little Susie. Well, what are we gonna tell mama? What are we gonna tell pop? What are we gonna tell our friends when they say, ooh la la, wake up, little Susie. Wake up, little Susie. Well, told your mama that we'd be invited. Susie, wake up, little Susie. We gotta go home. Wake up, little Susie, wake up. Wake up, little Susie, wake up. The movie wasn't so hot, it didn't have much of a plot. We fell asleep, our goose is cooked, our reputation is shot. Wake up, little Susie. Wake up, little Susie. Well, what are we gonna tell your mama? What are we gonna tell your pop? What are we gonna tell our friends when they say, ooh la la, wake up, little Susie. Wake up, little Susie. Wake up, little Susie. Wake up, little Susie.
You get some more Everly's. Someone new, she sure looks happy. I sure am blue. She was my baby till he stepped in. Goodbye to romance that might have been. Bye bye, love. Bye bye, happiness. Hello, loneliness. I think that I'm gonna cry. Hello, emptiness. I feel like I could die. Goodbye, my love, goodbye. I'm through with romance. I'm through with love. I'm through with counting the stars above. And here's the reason that I'm so free. My loving baby is through with.
Goodbye. All right.
Thank you so much. We're going to slow it down here now. This is one of their biggest ones. Beautiful ballad. They just don't write them like this anymore, but it's called All I Have to Do Is Dream. Thank you very much. I'm going to give you a couple of songs by my hero, but I got a fun story to tell you before we do some songs by my hero. When you think of Buddy Holly, what do you think of? You think of those glasses, right? You know? And he got that idea from the Everly Brothers. True story. They hit pretty big about a year and a half before Buddy Holly and the Crickets hit it. And these guys, they were already used to traveling all around the world. And they were living in New York, and so they were getting the preppiest clothes and the nicest jackets. And well, Buddy Holly and the Crickets, when they hit number one with their first song out of Lubbock, Texas, it happened so quickly for them. They were told to get ready for a concert tour, and so they went to their Sears and Roebuck in Lubbock, Texas, and they tried to get matching suits, and I think the suits just came in one size. And all four Crickets were of different size. And so they're on tour with the Everly Brothers, who, like I said, were quite used to being quite dapper. And they said, oh, man, we got to take you guys in. And then they told Buddy, you got to lose the glasses. And Buddy says, I can't see without my glasses. I mean, I can't see. And they said, well, if you're going to wear glasses, wear glasses. So they took him to this Italian shop down there in New York City, and he picked out those big, big glasses. So now when you think of those glasses, just know that the Everly Brothers out of Shenandoah gave that to Buddy Holly. Would you like to hear the first hit that Buddy Holly and the Crickets had? It shot them straight to number one. Here we go.
Well, that'll be the day when you say goodbye. Yes, that'll be the day when you make me cry. Say no.
money to hell. You say that, oh, me baby, I still you tell me maybe that someday will I be. Well, that'll be the day when you say goodbye. Yes, that'll be the day when you make the cry. You say you're gonna leave, you know it's a lie, but that'll be the day.
So much. Like I said, that song shot straight to number one. They recorded that in Clovis, New Mexico. Buddy Holly produced it himself. The band played it themselves. And the record industry was not used to this, okay? The record industry in the 50s, they were used to picking the singers, picking the songs, picking the producers. And they had a way to illegally get music onto the radio called payola. Well, Buddy Holly, he didn't need that. He was so good. Kids would just hear his music and go nuts and go buy his record and want to see him in concert. So the record industry, they were threatened by Buddy Holly, believe it or not, and they had quite an attitude towards him. And they walked up to him and they says, well, lucky break, kid. What do you got next? And Buddy just smiled, said, well, I got this song about a girl named Peggy Sue. I'm going to turn my guitar up this time.
If you knew Peggy Sue, then you know I remember that Peggy, my Peggy Sue. Well, I love you guys, I love you, Peggy Sue. Peggy Sue, oh how my heart yearns for you, oh Peggy, my Peggy Sue. Well, I love you, girl, won't you, Peggy Sue? Hey, Peggy Sue, Peggy Sue, oh pretty, 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 pretty Peggy Sue, oh Peggy. So rare and true, oh Peggy, my Peggy.
soon.
We'll love you, gal, on a won't you pay soon.
I love you, Peggy Sue, with a love so rare and true.
Thank you so much. Are you having a good time? See that guy walking right there in the gray jacket? That's Patrick Spradlin. Give him a hand for hiring us and bringing us out here today. He took a chance on this Minneapolis 50s band a handful of years ago, and I guess we won his good favor. We haven't done any Elvis Presley yet. That's just a shame. So many great songs from the 50s, and just this one afternoon, we're going to crowd them in as much as we can for you. How's that sound? We're going to give you a song here that kind of tells the story about how Elvis got his start. It was July 1954. He was recently graduated from high school. He was driving a truck, growing out his sideburns in the most beautiful pompadour God gave any man. And he was hearing all these great sounding records coming out of Sun's studio. The mad genius Sam Phillips had this place, and he was just making these otherworldly sounds, and he really knew how to tap into artists. So Elvis Presley went in there, and he was lying. He goes, "I want to record a couple of songs for my mama's birthday." So what you could do in those days, you could record two songs in the recording studio, and they would take your tape, and they would press it to something called an acetate. And then you could play that on 78 RPMs in the time. So we know Elvis was lying because his mother's birthday was still months away, but it was a smart move on Elvis's part because Sam Phillips and the secretary noticed there was something special about this kid. And so Sam Phillips brought Elvis Presley and a bassist named Bill Black and a guitarist named Scotty Moore. There were no drums. There were no drums on those early sessions. And so Sam Phillips is like, "Well, let's see what you got, guys." And so they fiddled around for a while. And Elvis, he imagined himself as a balladeer. And so he's like getting there and he's all warmed up. And Sam Phillips, the mad genius, hated it, absolutely hated it. And he stormed in. I'm not going to repeat verbatim what was said, but it rattled Elvis, and Elvis thought he was losing his chance. So I don't know if you know this about Elvis, he was a really, really shy guy. Now, he'd get on stage, and he was the most electric performer that ever lived, as far as I'm concerned. But then he just started hitting his guitar like this in just sheer nervousness. And then Bill Black started slapping this rockabilly bass. Scotty Moore starts doing this chicken picking. Sam Phillips runs into the room. "What in tarnation are you guys doing?" Elvis says, "Oh, man, I'm so sorry, Mr. Phillips, man. We're just messing around." Sam Phillips says, "Well, mess around some more. We have a hit here. I'm going to record this. Would you like to hear the song that broke Elvis Presley in 1954? All right, you're going to notice Levi's going to sit this one out because we're going to try to give you as accurate of a representation of that recording session as we can. The song's called "That's All Right, Mama." Are you ready, Lisa Lynn?
That's all right, Mama. That's all right for you. That's all right, Mama. Just about anything you do, that's all right. That's all right. That's all right now, Mama. Any way you do. Well, Mama, she done told me. Papa done told me too. Said, "Son, that girl you fooling with, she ain't no good for you." That's all right. That's all right. That's all right now, Mama.
Thank you. Well, I'm leaving town, baby. I'm leaving town for sure. Then you won't be bothered with me hanging round your door. That's all right. That's all right. That's all right now, mama. Anyway you do.
Thank you so much. Isn't she fun to watch play that bass? We get asked a lot, what is that? Is that a big violin? And I'm like, technically, yes, but it's a stand-up bass. And we're going to give you a kind of a little music history lesson here about just how this thing was so informative for this new music called rockabilly. Before rockabilly, bluegrass bands and country bands were playing the stand-up bass like this. It's nice, but then these younger guys, they started slapping the bass, and it kind of made more of a ruckus. And then they sped it up. Oh! That is the sound of my heart. I tell you, okay, I'm going to answer this question right now. How much older is he than her? I will just say this. I met her when she was 13. She was playing in her daddy's country band. And, well, we started dating when she was 18, and we married when she was 20. And like I told you, it was 20, 24 years of marriage. And I'll give you my age later. But I had a lot of friends. I said, Mark, what is taking you so long? I had friends with like married and kids and everything. Like, what's taking you so long? I said, well, I'm waiting for the most beautiful woman in the world. And she's got to play a rockabilly stand-up bass. And if she sings like Patsy Cline, my hands are tied. So, Lisa Lynn.
Aww.
We're going to give you the B-side. That song was put on an acetate by the mad genius Sam Phillips. He took it to a guy named Dewey Phillips at a radio station there in Memphis. No relations, but... The song was put on the air, and people were going nuts. Kids were just calling in. Who is this Elvis Presley? What is this new sound? We got to have it. So Sam Phillips knew he had a hit. So he called in the next day, Elvis, Bill, and Scotty. Said, you guys, speed up another one of those for me. And so they came up with this one. It's an old bluegrass song called Blue Moon of Kentucky.
Shining bright, blue moon, keep on shining bright. You're gonna bring me back to my baby tonight. Blue moon, keep shining bright. I said, blue moon of Kentucky, keep on shining. Shine on the one that's gone and left me blue. I said, blue moon of Kentucky, keep on shining. Shine on the one that's gone and left me blue. Well, it was on one moonlight night, stars shining bright, wish blown high, love say goodbye. The moon of Kentucky keep on shining, shine on the one that's gone and left me blue.
That song. We're going to give you a rockabilly tune here now. Brenda Lee was 9 years old when she recorded this next one.
I think it's about a shared phone line down in the bayou, but it sure is a fun song, and it's just pure rockabilly because that sound that Elvis and Scotty and Bill created, it just caught fire down in the South. And this thing called rockabilly. This might be one of my favorite rockabilly songs of all time. You ready, my dear?
Well, here's a number to call if you want my loving. A number to call if you want to double. A number I'm waiting all night long. Just waiting and I'm waiting for you to phone big love. 6200. What's the matter? What's the matter? Why don't you call? Don't you love your little baby no more at all? Sitting here waiting, not doing a thing. Just waiting for the doggone phone to ring. Big love. 6200.
Rockabilly. And Elvis kind of started turning it into rock and roll because he's hearing all kinds of other things. This next one, I'll be honest, it's my favorite Elvis song. It's called Rip It Up.
Well, it's Saturday night and I just got paid. Fool about my money, don't try to save. Hot sit, goo goo, have a time. Well, it's Saturday night and baby, I'm finna find a gonna rock it. I'm gonna rip it up. I'm gonna shake it. I'm gonna ball up, I'm gonna red up, and ball the night. Well, I got me a date and I won't be late. Picked her up in my 88, shagged on down by the social hall. Joint starts jumping, now I have a bomb. I'm gonna rock it up, I'm gonna rip it up, I'm gonna shake it up, gonna ball up, I'm gonna red up, and ball the night. To the open sky. Now I don't care how I spend my dough. I'm gonna be one happy song. I'm gonna rock it up. Yeah, I'm gonna rip it up. I'm gonna shake it up. Gonna ball it up. Ball it up. And ball the night. Well, I got me a date and I won't be late. Picked her up in my 88. Shagged on down by the social hall.
So now rockabilly started turning into rock and roll, and there was a guy named Chuck Berry, who was already established blues artist, and he goes, man, I know what these kids are doing. They're just taking the blues and speeding it up. He was almost 30 when he recorded this next song. He realized these kids were into cars and girls, so he wrote this song called Maybelline. I love this song, just by the way. Just watch what happens.
so motivating over the hill. I saw Maybelline in a coupe to fill. Cadillac run on a Hoban road. Nothing I run my V84. Cadillac tour by 9 to 5 road. I'm bumping a bump on the side to side. Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? Well, you done something about doing the things you used to do. Well, the Cadillac pulled up 104. The Ford got hot, wouldn't do no more. Tongue got cloudy, it's starting to rain. I took my horn for a passing lane. Rain water blowing right under the hood. Well, I knew that I was doing my motor good. Maybelline, why can't you be true?
Oh, Maybelline,
why can't you be true? Well, you done something about doing the things you used to do.
So much. So then rock and roll was going, and this could arguably be the biggest rock and roll song of that era, and actually got famous because it was being in a movie, The Blackboard Jungle. Anybody heard of that movie? Sidney Poitier was in it, but the movie became problematic because every time the song came on, kids got out of their seats and were dancing in the aisles, so they started banning the movie. But the record industry goes, we have a hit here. The first time I heard this song, who remembers the show Happy Days? I loved that show until Fonzie jumped the shark. But before that, it's like my dad, he prepped me big time because he knew I loved this rock and roll stuff. He says, why don't you watch this show with me? And the show opened up. Remember? It was the jukebox. And the song comes out and a platter is dropped onto the jukebox. Needle hits it and it's this song. I'm like, Daddy, what is this? He goes, it's Bill Haley in the Comets, Rock Around the Clock. I'm like, I like this. This is what I do for a living now. I think a seed was planted, huh? Would you like to hear the song that Bill Haley in the Comets kind of knocked it out of the park with? All righty. One, two, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're going to rock around. Gonna rock, gonna
Then start a rock and around the clock again. Gonna rock around the clock tonight. Gonna rock, 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 rock tonight. Gonna rock around the clock tonight.
And rock and roll was in full form. What I love about rock and roll, it was bringing all kinds of races together in music. I mean, blacks could be on the charts now. Hispanics could be on the charts. And we have a big, big connection with this next guy. Who here's heard of Richie Valens? All righty. We have been so fortunate in our travels to be able to play at the Surf Ballroom in Clear Lake, Iowa. Anybody know about that place? All righty. For the rest of you, it's like, it's the last place Buddy Holly, Richie Valens, and the Big Bopper performed in before they sadly got on that airplane and died in a cornfield just a few miles north of it. But what they do in Iowa every year, they call it the Winter Dance Party, because in February 2nd, 1959, those guys were on a tour called the Winter Dance Party. And so Clear Lake, Iowa, they said, we are not going to be remembered as the town where the music died. We're going to be remembered as the town where the music lives. So they continue to do this winter dance party. And I thought my band would be perfect for this. So I sent our CD and our promo package. A whole year goes by, nothing. So I wait another year. I sent another CD and a promo package. I wait a whole year and nothing. And then finally, I just did a Hail Mary. I sent two packages. 6 months go by. What's the word I'm about to use, everybody? Nothing. But then finally, it was like a fall day, very similar to this. Lisa came home with this confused look on her face, and she's holding her phone, and she said, you got a phone call from the Surf Ballroom. I'm like, what? She says, yeah, they want you to call them back. I'm like, all right. So I called them up and said, hi, Mark Flora here from the Holy Rocka Rollaz, just returning your call. And there was just like this awkward silence on the phone. And then the guy just says, I don't even know why I called you. I said, well, you might need a band for this upcoming winter dance party, you know? And I would say, ha, nice try, kid. First of all, I want to tell you something. I don't know how on earth your package got put on my desk. My secretary knows to throw everything that comes in the mail into the garbage. I never open any of these. I get hundreds of them a year. Somehow yours ended on my desk, and some reason I actually opened it. And I'm like, these guys might have a role to play here. He goes, I still don't know why that happened. I said, oh, I know why. He's like, why? I go, because Buddy Holly told you to. He laughed and lightened up a little bit. And he says, I got a humble opportunity for you. I said, let's do it. And he goes, what, do you want to hear what it is first? I'm like, I think if you see my band, you'll like us. And so he goes, well, I want you guys to play a hamburger luncheon dance at the Best Western Banquet Hall. I'm like, all right, let's do it. Well, it must have gone well, because in the back of the room was this beautiful woman, and I mean beautiful. And for 2 hours, she was staring at me like this. She's even walking over and grabbing her friends and pointing at me, and I'm just like this. I still got it. And so I figured when our show was done, she was going to walk up to the stage and talk to me. And sure enough, she did. And she just said, I want to thank you for keeping 50s rock and roll alive. You understand how it should be played, how it should be sung. But most of all, you understand the spirit of this music. And I said, wow, thank you so much. My name is Mark Flora. And she goes, hi, I'm Connie Valens, Richie Valens' little sister. I couldn't believe it. My jaw dropped. I had to jump back and kiss myself twice. And then she says, I'm going to come see the Holy Rocka Rollaz. Every time you're here in Iowa, and folks, she's an aunt to our two daughters, and we're going to be celebrating her, I don't know if she wants me. Yeah, her 70th birthday. We're going to be celebrating it in Iowa next month, and she lives in Spirit Lake, Iowa. And sure enough, we were in Spirit Lake, Iowa at a theater, and we started playing a Richie Valens song, and she came onto the stage, and she goes, may I sing this with you? And I'm like, yes. And then my body and my soul just kind of separated for a little bit. I'm floating over the stage watching Richie Valens' little sister sing her brother's song with us. Life is good, isn't it? Would you like to hear that song that she sang with us? All right, here we go. It's called We Belong Together. ¶¶
together. Yes, we belong together for eternity. You're mine. Your lips belong to me. Yes, they belong to only me for eternity. You're mine, my baby, and you always be. I swear by everything I own, you'll always, always be mine. You're mine, and we belong together. Yes, we belong together for eternity.
Thank you.
I go out walking after midnight, out in the moonlight, just like we used to do. I'm always walking after midnight, searching for you. I walked for miles along the highway. Well, that's just my way of saying I love you. I'm always walking after midnight, searching for you. I stopped to see a weeping willow crying on his pillow. Maybe he's crying for me. And as the skies turn gloomy, night winds whisper to me, lonesome as I can be. I go out walking after midnight, out in the starlight, just hoping you may be somewhere walking after midnight, searching for me. Just hoping you may be somewhere walking after midnight, searching for me.
The first 8 years of my life were spent in San Antonio, Texas, Lackland Air Force Base. My daddy served in the United States Air Force. And when you get the San Antonio rose in your blood, you never let it go. is written by Bob Wills and his Texas Playboys, and Patsy Cline took a shot at it. But it came out kind of like this.
Deep within my heart lies a melody, a song of old San Antonio, where in dreams I live with a memory beneath the stars all alone. Well, it was there I found beside the Alamo enchantment strange as the blue above. For that moonlit past that only he would know, still hears my broken song of love. Moon in all your splendor, known only to my heart, call me my rose, rose of San Antonio. Lips so sweet and tender, like petals falling apart. Speak once again, oh my love, my own broken song. Empty words I know, still live in my heart all alone. For that moonlit pass by the Alamo, my rose of San Antonio.
Thank you so much. We're going to give you some songs by a Minnesotan now. Eddie Cochran, a pioneer of early American rock and roll, is in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, deservedly so. Born in Albert Lea, right here in Minnesota. And what they do down there is they celebrate it, that he was born then. They call it Eddie Cochran Days, and they do it every first weekend of June. And we were there a couple of summers ago. We would have been there this year, but, well, COVID. We would have been a lot of places this year. But can I tell you how grateful we are that we're here with you today? Really, thank you for showing up today. This is probably our last show of the year, sadly, because things start cooling down, as we know. And our Christmas shows are canceling, and then we usually do a couple of tours down south, and they're starting to cancel. So I'm just going to give you everything I got today. How's that sound? So getting back to Eddie Cochran, we were playing at a car show that day, and there were just tons of beautiful cars and great people, but there was this lady, and she had to have been in her 80s, but she had the youth of a 40-year-old gal. She was bopping and dancing. Wow, that lady's having a great time. Well, she came up to us at the end of our performance, and she says, "Oh, Eddie would have loved you." I'm like, "Okay." She goes, "Well, I'm his sister. I would know." "Well, thank you so much." She goes, "So many of these 50s bands, they cheese it up. And like, you guys play rock and roll like it was supposed to be done." I'm like, "Wow, you're the second sister to tell me this. Woo, that's verification." Would you like to hear a couple of Eddie Cochran songs here? Minnesota's own Eddie Cochran.
No dice, and you gotta work late.
Sometimes I wonder how am I gonna do, but there ain't no cure for the summertime blues. Well, my mama, papa told me, son, you gotta earn some money.
go riding next Sunday. Well, I didn't go to work, told the boss I was sick. He said you can't use the car cause you didn't work a leg. Sometimes I wonder, I'm gonna do, but there ain't no cure for the summertime blues. I want to take my travel to the United Nations. Well, I called my congressman and he said, quote, I'd like to help you, son, but you're too young to vote. Sometimes I wonder, I'm gonna do if there ain't no cure for the summertime blues.
This next one's by Eddie, also called 20 Flat Rock.
Well, I got a gal with a record machine. When it comes to rock, she's a queen. Love her dance on Saturday night, all alone, rockin' hold her tight. But she lives on the 20th floor of town. The elevator's broken down, so I climb 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. I'm on 12, starting to drag. 15th floor, I'm ready to sag. Get to the top, I'm too tired to rock. Well, she called me up on the telephone, said, come over, honey, I'm all alone. I said, oh, baby, you're mighty sweet, but I'm in bed with a aching feet. This went on for a couple of days. I couldn't bear to stay away, so I climb on 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm on 12, starting to jack. 15, 4, I'm ready to sag. Get to the top, I'm too tired to rock. Using the stairs, hope to hurry before I'm too late. I love my baby too much to wait. All this climbing is getting me down. If I'm a cove straight over a hill, so I climb 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm on 12, starting to drag. 15, 4, I'm ready to sag. Get to the top, I'm too tired to rock.
It's not vodka. I've been asked. Skull. They always say save your best songs for last. You want to hear her sing another Patsy Cline one? I do too. This next one is written by a genius. And he originally called the song Stupid. But he was a really smart guy, so he realized if he just changed the lyrics to Crazy, it'd be a hit. Willie was right. Here we go.
Crazy. I'm crazy for feeling so lonely. Crazy. I'm crazy for feeling so blue. I knew you loved me as long as you wanted.
someday you'd leave me for somebody new. Worry, why do I let myself worry? Wondering what in the world did I do? Crazy for thinking that my love would hold you. I'm crazy for trying and crazy for crying, and I'm crazy for loving you. Crazy for thinking that my love would hold you. I'm crazy for trying and crazy for crying, and I'm crazy for loving you.
Thank you. Hopefully I didn't get stung just now.
Yeah, if you've seen me dancing badly up here, I'm dodging hornets and wasps. So, or I just dance badly too. So, this was a big hit for Elvis. I don't know if the song made the movie or the movie made the song, but they both go together, and you're going to know it in two notes.
Born to a party in the county jail. Prison bands that never can or will. Better jump on any jump again to swing. Shooter the rock, top jet bird singer. Let's rock. Everybody, let's rock. Everybody in the old cell block. We're dancing to the jail, let's rock. Striding with a plaintiff and a saxophone. Little jump blowing on the side trombone. Drummer boy from Illinois, we'll crash, boom, bam. Whole rhythm section was the purple game. Let's rock. Everybody, let's rock. Everybody in the old cell block. We're dancing to the jail. Number 47 said number 3. You're the cutest shepherd I ever did see. Should be delighted with your company. Come on into the jail, let's rock with me. Let's rock. Everybody, let's rock. Everybody in the whole cell block. We'll dance to the jail, let's rock. Heaven's sake, the water looking down, chance to make a break. Bucket jump to shifty, and he said, nicks, nicks. I won't stay around, wanna get my kick. Let's rock. Everybody, let's rock. Everybody in our own cell block. We'll dance to the jail, let's rock. Dance to the jail, let's rock. Dance to the jail, let's rock. And we'll dance to the jail, let's rock.
What brings us to the last show of the day? Have you had a good time today? I'm going to tell you something. Years ago, maybe a couple of decades, we were early in our marriage, and Lisa woke up from a nightmare, and she said, "Honey, what? I had the weirdest dream." I'm like, "What?" She goes, "That you died playing Johnny B. Goode by Chuck Berry." "Okay, well, what did I look like in this dream?" She's like, "Well, your hair was white and receding. And it's really weird. We were outside, like, on a fall day." "Well, I hope they have me back in 20 years, okay? As I don't plan on dying on you today, all right?" Chuck Berry's Johnny B. Goode.
living near the trees of Moore Railroad Track. And it's Miss sitting, sitting out of the shade, drumming to the rhythm that the drivers made. People passing by would always stop and say, well, mama, dad, they didn't got a cocaine break. Go, Johnny, go, go. To hear you play your guitar when the sun goes down. Maybe someday your name might be in lights. Will Johnny be good tonight? I'll sing out. Go, Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Johnny, be good. Lisa Land. We are the Holy Rocka Rollaz, and we hope we get to see you again. Much Brainerd and Baxter. What a great time. Woo! You want one more? You want two more? We'll see if we'll see if the officer will let us go over time. Three more. All right, I tell you what. We also love country gospel. We're going to give a couple of great ones here. So, if you can't make it to church tomorrow, if you sing and clap along with this one, you're covered, okay? Pastor Mark said so. I'm self-ordained, by the way.
When I die, hallelujah, by and by. I wandered so aimless, life filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night.
Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw.
The blind man I wandered along. Worries and fears I claimed for my own. And just like the blind man, God gave back his sight.
Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow.
This is our final number. It's a Buddy Holly one called Raven.
Well, hey, I said little things you say and do made me want to be with you. Raven, it's a crazy feeling. I know it's got me really when you say I love you.
So much again. Should Patrick bring us back someday soon? We would love to be back here. God bless all of you. Get home safe. And Skull Vikings.